shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging water in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you who weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked men insult and hate you all because of me, blessed, blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. And I will give you rest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. Good afternoon to you all, to those who have traveled a distance to be here today, as we offer the holy sacrifice of this Mass for the repose of Oliver Perkins' soul. We commend Oliver on this day to the grace and mercy of Almighty God, and we ask our Blessed Mother, Mary Most Holy, to accompany Oliver on his journey home to his eternal reward. We pray for Oliver today. We pray also for Oliver's family, for his beloved wife, Kathleen, for his sons, Liam and Conor, and to his devoted grandchildren, Keely, Ruby, Macy, Kyson. We remember his sister Bridget and his daughters-in-law, Lauren and Melissa, brothers-in-law, sisters-in-law, nephew nieces, grand-nieces, grand-nephews, extended family, and a wide circle of friends. We pause now in a moment as we unite ourselves in prayer with Liam, who is joining us on the web link from Perth in Australia. Liam, we are with you. We are here also praying for you on this day, that God may grant you his consolation, his courage, and his strength. In life, all of us cherish the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life, come blessed of my Father. In baptism, all of us receive the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. And now there will be symbols representing the interests in Oliver's life, and the significance of those symbols will be read for us by Greta.
Before we begin Oliver's funeral mass, we present symbols of what was important to him in life. Ruby and Macy, Oliver's grandchildren, present family photos which represent his great love for his family. Patrick presents a hurley and Oliver's medals, representing his achievements and love of sports. Conor, his much-loved son, presents Oliver's cap, a staple part of his wardrobe. Oliver had many great achievements in his professional life. The project he was most proud of was the Mary McAleese Bridge. Nancy presents a photo of this bridge. Saoirse presents a crossword, which is left unfinished. This seldom happened, as Oliver had a great determination and loved the challenge of completing them on a daily basis.
We also like to welcome Father Tony Ryan, who will concelebrate Oliver's funeral mass, and welcome him from Tipperary and all those who have travelled today. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our failings as we ask our merciful Father for pardon and strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Oliver, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We now listen to the scripture readings, which will be read to us by Mary and Billy.
First reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they disappear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like annihilation, but they are in peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand, and hold you in the palm of his
Second reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. He who raised the Lord Jesus to life will raise us with Jesus in our turn, and put us by his side, and you with us. You see, all this is for your benefit, so that the more grace is multiplied among people, the more thanksgiving there will be to the glory of God. That is why there is no weakening on our part, and instead, though this outer man of ours may be falling into decay, the inner man is renewed day by day. Yes, the troubles which are soon over, though they weigh little, train us for the carrying of a weight of eternal glory, which is out of all proportion to them. And so we have no eyes for things that are visible, but only for things that are invisible. For visible things last only for a time, and the invisible things are eternal. For we know that when the tent that we live in on earth is folded up, there is a house built by God for us, an everlasting home not made by human hands in the heavens. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. As we heard the words of the responsorial psalm sung so beautifully, it is perhaps reflecting on those words that those words become much more than words, but rather they give us meaning and consolation and hope. He will raise you up on eagle's wings and hold you in the palm of his hand. As we continue to journey through the season of Easter to God our Father's ascension into heaven, when he will be raised up on eagle's wings, for God his Father will hold him in the palm of his hand. It is those words that are a reality, for our faith is a reminder that on this day, that all of our soul too will be raised up on eagle's wings, and that God our Father will hold him in the palm of his hand. For at Easter we are reminded, as we are each day of our lives, that as the Paschal candle flickers brightly in front of Oliver's coffin, it reminds us that the darkness of the empty tomb was filled with light on Easter Sunday morning. For the light of faith is the light that guides our lives too. It is the light of faith that offers us consolation, courage, strength, and hope, even in death. For our faith is a reminder that even in death, as the words in the Mass says, life is changed, but not ended. As we commend all of our soul to Almighty God today, we do so in the knowledge of our faith, in the gift of eternal life. For all of our this is not the end, but merely the beginning. the beginning to his eternal reward, which we will each receive on our appointed day. From the day of our baptism, we receive that pledge from God our Father that we will share in that great gift of life eternal. Let us take consolation in our faith this day. Let our lives be guided by the flicker of the flame of the Paschal candle. For Oliver's life began in Drumban in County Tipperary, growing up in a large family. After his primary school, Oliver went to the Christian Brothers School in Turles, where he cycled each day. And it was during his years in secondary school that his gifts and talents, particularly on the hurling field, quickly became noticed. It was his gifts and talents and skill of hurling that was nurtured during his years in secondary school, which brought him to an inter-county hurling final and many achievements on and off the field. Hurling was only one part of Oliver's life. He had an immense interest in many other sports as well. He was a keen rugby player and coached Perth Leash Town on their first Towns Cup victory, a remarkable achievement, but yet it was Oliver's skill and his talent and his integrity that led the team to victory. Also, his gift of golf also, being the first captain of Knightsbrook Golf Club and then proceeding to be president, playing in many golf courses throughout the country, and his love of swimming also, being an instructor, handing on those necessary skills of life-saving. And of course, in more recent years, his interest in sport never waned, but always was to the fore as he played outdoor bowls here in Trim. His many visits to Marcy's, chatting with friends and family, and of course, keeping an eye on the sports, and in particular, his beloved Tipperary. It's true to say that Tipperary always had a special place in Oliver's heart. Our life can take many twists and turns, many different journeys. And I think in June 1975, Oliver's life took another journey, or perhaps another twist. It was the first time he met Kathleen Doran from Greg Namana at Kathleen's brother's ordination that their friendship began, and it was nourished and flourished and grew. And I think it was a romance that was love at first sight. I think Kathleen will agree. It was in July 1976 that Oliver and Kathleen confirmed their life in the gift of love, in that same love that God our Father gives to each one of us as his Son offered his life on the cross, a gift of infinite love. And it was that love that Oliver and Kathleen shared for each other that was blessed in their two sons, Liam and Conor, whom Oliver was extremely proud of, your achievements and your accomplishments in life. And also in more recent years, the gift and the birth of his grandchildren brought him great joy and happiness also to Keely and Kyson, Ruby and Macy. You brought a ray of light and sunshine to Oliver's life. After his school years, Oliver travels to UCD in Dublin, where he studied in engineering and qualified as an engineer. His work brought him all over Ireland, working with Dublin County Council, Leash County Council, and then in 1987, he became a county engineer with Meath County Council. Oliver and Kathleen established and settled here in Trim, a home that Oliver was very proud of. He was very proud of the heritage and in the history of the town of Trim that surrounded him at Echo Gate. A beautiful view each morning to wake up to, a beautiful reminder of the history and the heritage of this lovely town. His gifts at work, his integrity, his dedication, his love of work was always to the fore. And Oliver and Kathleen enjoyed their trips to Spain and also in 2016 to Australia. And when many of us might agonize over what we'll put in our suitcase, what we'll add or what we'll take out, Oliver was only concerned with one thing, and that was his crossword. His crossword and thesaurus was never too far away, was always close at hand. He enjoyed the simple things in life, his daily walk, his newspaper, the crosswords, but above all, his family, his beloved wife Kathleen, Liam, and Conor, his grandchildren. And on Saturday, when I spoke to Kathleen, I think Kathleen beautifully summed up Oliver's life in a few short, simple, profound words. Kathleen said that Oliver was a man of integrity, a kind, compassionate man, a gentle, gentle soul. May Oliver's soul rest in eternal peace. May God welcome him in the palm of his hand and grant him his eternal reward. We stand together for the prayers of the faithful. Let us in faith call upon God, the Almighty Father, who raised Christ, his Son, from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
The first prayer of the faithful will be read by Oliver's granddaughter, Keely.
We pray for Granddad Oliver. May God welcome him into his heavenly home of happiness and peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the family of Oliver, especially his wife, Kathleen, and his sons, Conor and Liam, who cannot be with us. His grandchildren, Keely, Ruby, Macy and Kyson. His sister, Bridget, and extended family. May God comfort and console them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those whose lives are dedicated to the sick, in particular, the doctors, nurses, and staff of Our Lady's Hospital, Navan, who cared for Oliver with great kindness and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for our neighbours and friends. May God reward them for their kindness and support. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for peace in our world, especially in Ukraine. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who are ill and suffering at this time. May God lay his healing hands on them and give them the courage and hope. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for young people. May they value goodness, kindness, and friendship. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the elderly.
May they always receive the love, care, and respect from family and friends. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Oliver. May God unite them all in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We pause in a moment of silence and offer our own personal prayer. Lord, hear us. We pray on this day, especially for Oliver's son, Liam. We ask God to grant them his healing power, to restore him to full health. We ask God to bless him with strength, courage, determination, perseverance, integrity, all the gifts that his father lived in life. We ask this and all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. We now have the offertory procession with the gifts of bread and wine brought forward by Michael and Melissa. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands in praise and glory of his name, and the Father of his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Oliver may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Tom, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Oliver, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow in the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds veil the sky, God is by my side. Even when the the sun shall fall in sleep. Even when at dawn the sky shall weep. Even in the night when storms shall rise, God is by my side. God is by my side. Bright the stars at night that mirror heaven's way to you. Bright the stars in light where dwell the saints in love and truth. Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds veil the sky, God is by my side. Even when the sun shall fall in sleep, even when at dawn the sky shall weep, even in the night when storms shall rise, God is by my side. God is by my side.
We all stand in the light. He's my forever friend, my leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. Even when I turn away, he cares for me. His love no one can shake. Even as I walk away, he's by my side. With every breath I take. And sometimes I forget him. My halo fails to shine. Sometimes I am not his friend, but he is always he's my forever friend, my leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. He's my forever friend.
I invite Gemma now to come forward and read a poem.
When I must leave you for a little while. When I must leave you for a little while, please do not grieve and shed wild tears and hug your sorrow to you through the years. But start out bravely with a gallant smile, and for my sake and in my name, live on and do all things the same. Feed not your loneliness on empty days, but fill each waking hour in useful ways. Reach out your hand, and in comfort and in cheer, and in turn, I will comfort you and hold you near. And never, never be afraid to die, for I am waiting for you in the sky. Rest in peace, Oliver.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Oliver, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Oliver, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Oliver again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. I now sprinkle Oliver's coffin with holy water as a symbol of the sacrament of baptism and the gift of eternal life, and then honor Oliver's coffin with incense.
Response now, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Oliver in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Oliver in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. On behalf of Father Paul, Father Tony and myself, we offer our deepest sympathies to Oliver's family. We assure you of our prayers, thoughts and sympathies, condolence on behalf of ourselves and the parish community. For Oliver's beloved wife, Kathleen, for his sons, Liam, and for Conor, and for his adoring grandchildren, for Keely, Ruby, Macy, and Kyson, daughters-in-law, Lauren, and Melissa, and to Oliver's sister, Bridget, brothers-in-law, sisters-in-law, nephew, nieces, grand-nephews, grand-nieces, extended family, and a wide circle of friends. And before we take Oliver to his place of rest, perhaps each one of us can say together the prayer of the guardian angel. We will say this prayer. We will offer this prayer for Liam, Lauren, Keelan, and Kyson in Perth. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side to light and guard, to rule and guide. Thank you to Gwen and Mary in the gallery, for Louise, who played during the offertory, for all who took part in the readings and prayers of the faithful, to Father Tony for travelling from Tipperary today to be with Oliver's family, and to Aidan, Niall and Fergal. In peace, let us take our brother Oliver to his place of rest.
Thank you.
Let us assist Oliver with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he is our life, appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world." Lord Jesus Christ, for your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallow the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother Oliver may sleep here in peace, until you awaken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life, then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Because God has chosen to call our brother Oliver from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. For our brother Oliver, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Oliver, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our brother Oliver eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Oliver. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallow the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restore us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Oliver, and for all who have died in Christ, and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us unite our prayers with those of our Blessed Mother, Mary Most Holy, as we say the first decade of the glorious mysteries, the resurrection, for the repose of all of our soul. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto all of our Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May all of our soul, and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now Katrina is going to read for us a message from Liam.
These are just a few words from Liam, who we all know unfortunately can't be home from Australia due to health reasons. Dad, I can't believe I'm sitting here writing these words for your funeral and not being able to support Mum and Conor. It breaks my heart. Dad, from a very young age, you started handing me down the jigsaw pieces of life to myself and Conor. It wasn't until my early 30s that I realised fully on how to put most of these together to become a good family man. I can still hear you saying, Liam, do the toughest things first and it will get easier. Never shy away from anything that's tough, especially as I write this. You had the biggest of hearts, Dad, not just for us, but for everyone that knew you. It showed by how popular you were. We're so proud of your sporting achievements. Playing hurling for Tipperary, played managed Portlaoise Rugby Club to win its first Towns Cup. Captain of Heath Golf Club Portlaoise, Captain President of Knightsbrook Golf Club, swimming teacher, national coach for the 1906 Paralympics. However, you didn't attend this. You married Mum instead. You reached the peak of your professional career coming to Meath as county engineer in 1987 and settling in Trim. Your job was very rewarding and always done with diligence and integrity. You loved taking Conor and I to see some of the major projects in which you were involved. You were so happy to see Trim develop into the beautiful heritage town that it is today. You had such a brilliant mind that you were our human calculator. You were the master of crosswords. If we had a question, no matter how hard or what the topic was, you always knew the answer. Your wit, you were so smart and quick with jokes. Your dad jokes were the best. I'm so grateful that yourself and Mom made it out to Australia. We have such great memories that we can cherish forever. You were so proud of all your grandkids. They brought you so much love and happiness. There will always be a special place in their hearts for their granddad. I'm so sorry that COVID and my health have robbed us of any extra time we could have spent together, but we made up for it though by Skyping, sending videos and photos. Dad, you were the kindest soul, the kindest man with the gentlest of souls. I'm so thankful for everything you have done for us, everything you have taught me, and more importantly, I wouldn't be the person that I am today, I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for you and Mam. I will always hold you close to my heart, Dad. Love you forever. Till we meet again, Liam.
The family would like to invite you for refreshments in Knightsbrook Hotel.
Oliver's mother came from a place called Timpelderry, so I think they requested this song on account of where he came from. Sweet home of my childhood, there is nowhere like thee. Thy mountains, thy wild woods, the vale and the lea. Where'er in this world we ever might roam, I will never forget you, Templederry, my home. Where the cascades roll down, the sweet mountains between, and the moon it shines came on the breast of Moonin. Where bright rivers sparkle their feathery foam, on the shamrock decked vale of Templederry, my home. Our beautiful church, it stands tall in the air, while the angelus bells calls the people to prayer. Our beautiful bell tower, with its high ringing tone, seems to say, heaven bless you, Kilcommon, my home. Sweet home of my childhood, there's nowhere like thee. Thy mountains, thy wild woods, the vale and the lea. Where'er in this wide world, wherever I roam, I will never forget you, Templederry, my home.
Thank you. Thank you.